Yeah, so I'll be talking about the, so if suppose you have a blockchain-based application running on 100 or 1000 of nodes, and you want a customized platform, cloud platform where you can interact with your blockchain nodes where you are, have your running blockchain-based application like the trading platform and for credit transparency and suppose you have a KYC verification and blockchain-based application. So I'll be talking about some of the tools which you can integrate with the Apache Brooklyn. So this is the image I used, like the Brooklyn Bridge. So this is about the, so this is the open source project Apache Brooklyn. So I'll be using to deploy, manage and control the cloud platform. And these are the two tools, Clocker 2.0 and CloudSort MP. So I'll be talking in the next slide about these tools, how you can use these tools to visualize and monitor your all the blockchain nodes or blockchain or Ethereum nodes where your thousands or hundreds of applications are running on the blockchain or Ethereum nodes. So I'll be starting with the CloudSoft MP. So this is an open source project which actually an infrastructure based cloud service. So it's an open source project, and so you can use this tool with the Clocker 2.0 to manage and interact with your 100 blockchain-based applications running on blockchain or Ethereum network. So CloudSort MP actually solves. So MP is actually the application management platform, and this is the problem solving which actually solves the. So as we have a 100 blockchain-based or Ethereum-based applications running on blockchain or corresponding Ethereum network. And these are the problems, so like you have a large and complex ecosystem where you have implemented functions block as a smart contract or chain code from scratch, like as a smart contract as a chain code on Hyperledger Fabric. So Hyperledger Fabric is one of the solutions, but it does not work on the ES node resources. So we have a problem like fast moving, like we have a every copy of transactions on our chain is called the ledger. And so complex deployments like suppose we have a 50 or 100 of blockchain based applications running on a blockchain or Ethereum node, and it makes the process complex to interact with all those real nodes at the same time that what so what is going on my blockchain or Ethereum node. And there is an inconsistent document. It's very tough to prepare the documents of all those blockchain and like the registry, it is maintained on the particular blockchain or Ethereum node. So suppose we have 50 to 100 nodes of blockchain or Ethereum. So this is one of the major problem. And like a runtime manual, like the health policies in the your cluster. So this is the Apache Brooklyn. So this is the process of Apache Brooklyn project, which is used for the cloud platform, the application management system in the cloud software. So this is the model where it actually takes Apache Tomcat. Like there are several artifacts of jar files or YAML files with the Apache Tomcat and MySQL with the load balancer. So this will use to instance it, and it will deploy the dynamic live model, like the latency issues and the velocity factors along. And it maintains at every level, like it so it will probably help you with the temperature and all these differences where so these problems can be solved with this Apache Brooklyn, and I have already deployed it on the CloudSoft MP platform. So you can use this to interact with your 50 to 100 blockchain or Ethereum nodes. So this is the structure of Cloud MP, and so Cloud MP actually consists of several tools. It made up of it uses different tools to build this whole CloudSoft MP project. So based on Tigra tools, Nginx, Spark, SAP HANA, these all tools. So CloudSoft MP contains of these several infrastructure agnostic. So this is the, suppose you have a physical servers like data centers like this. And these are the virtual server, like we have a VM running on for the different nodes to monitor and all. So it also works for the local private dedicated server, like you're running in an OpenStack platform or cloud platform, or suppose you have a public AWS or software, IBM or Microsoft Azure. So this cloud software MP contains all those, it works for all these cloud platforms. Like if you have a data center where you are managing all those blockchain or Ethereum nodes. So the advantage of this cloud software MP is the runtime management. So it helps you to manage the deployed application and the policies, like the health policies and other policies with the application specific matrix. So you can indicate these specific matrix in your YAML file or the artifacts of jar files. So you can include all this in your artifacts. And so there are different metrics like latency or transactions per second, or the registry is going on in the blockchain Ethereum network, the nodes you are running for your particular application, blockchain based applications. And so there are several operations where you can manage with it. So there are advantages of scaling, failover, and service monitoring, which is added advantage over the blueprint. So blueprint is actually the artifacts. So blueprint here means the artifacts, like the one in jar files or the YAML files. And there are more advantages like the reliable cloud native applications. So you can figure it out on the CloudSoft MP platform. Now the one which is deployed on the Apache Brooklyn. And so also the so at the infra level there are several management issues. We have, like the suppose you have a suppose you have an internet interruption, like suppose the internet has been suppose you got, so there is a sync of solution where you can sync from the last interruption. So it also have an added advantage of diverse platform, like suppose you have a different applications, like you are using a different so CloudSoft MP is a customized application where you can use different types of non-SQL databases like Cassandra, Hive, MongoDB, anything. So this is an added advantage that you can use it to club your all the applications and monitor from the Apache Brooklyn platform. So this is about a Clocker. And I'm going to talk about the Clocker 2.0. This is the tool combined with the CloudSoft AMP, which you can integrate with the Apache Brooklyn. So Clocker 2.0 is a, so these are the use cases of Clocker 2.0. So it's a series of open source blueprints. Open source blueprints is just a combination of different YAML or several artifacts of jar files. So it's for the Swarm and Kubernetes. Swarm is a Docker Swarm, and the Kubernetes is used for orchestrating the function blocks. The function blocks here is a smart contract or change code. So in terms of, if you talk about the enterprise blockchain hyperledger, so we've got this change code. So these blueprints contain different chain codes in a, called in a separate YAML artifacts of jar files. So it also simplifies the deployments of different YAML files in a containerized like Docker Swarm. So I'll be using the so in the next coming slide I'll show you that how you use the Docker Swarm and what are the YAML files I'll be using for the deploying the Hyperledger fabric under. So this is the Docker Swarm blueprint where there are different services, like so here I used so this Docker Swarm service works on the, so this is for the three nodes. So you have to mention those parameters for your particular blockchain or Ethereum nodes you are going to. So there is a type Docker Swarm, ID Swarm, so you can mention it anything according to what the Docker Swarm container name. And there is a Brooklyn config. This is for the Apache Brooklyn. This interaction. So Apache Brooklyn is basically is a customized cloud platform where you can monitor or model or deploy and manage your systems. So here, system is managing all the different blockchain or Ethereum real nodes for your different blockchain based applications. So you can set these parameters like the start timeout time, the 30 minutes, and these are the initial size of the container, Docker Swarm container. So this Docker Swarm container actually implement the function blocks. So function blocks here is a smart contract. So these are the different parameters like maximum size, manager size, etc. So etc is used for distributed storage over here. So what are the files which you are calling in your smart contract code? So you can use so there is a availability of currently availability of only Solidity. There is no Viper integration for this. So there are two different Solidity languages. The one is Solidity and the second is the Viper written in Python. So there has not been any support of Viper over here. So this is the on one side there is a public network. So public network is the blockchain or Ethereum network. So the one you are interacting with. So you can interact that. You can use the combination of Ethereum and blockchain node to interact with, or you can interact with the only blockchain or the Ethereum network. So public network is actually a blockchain or Ethereum network. And on the one side, there is a Kubernetes cluster, the 3 million nodes. And so it contains the load balancing. So the network, Ethereum or blockchain network directly interacts with the load balancer. It's called the Docker Swarm Manager. That what the nodes they are packaged. So this Kubernetes cluster actually auto scales all the time, depending on the requirements you have for a particular application. And this is the TLS, the certified CS server on the site. So you can use the AWS TLB as well to share with your etc distributed node. And so this is the so if you log into the CloudShark, there is a free tab. So you can use it. So this is the Docker Swarm. Node, the blueprint I already shown in the last one. So you can use this to deploy on the, so this is for the three blockchain or Ethereum nodes. So those nodes are have been, so it depends on what you are using. So suppose you have a blockchain network running on an AWS node. So you have to mention those endpoints on that under the YAML file and call it in the Docker Swarm. So here it is. So if you have a CloudSoft AMP enterprise account, you can go with the 50 to 100 nodes. And for free tariff, they are giving around 50. I did not remember the exact number of nodes they are giving. So you can here also, if you navigate down, there are several Kube components like the Kube API server, Kubelets, and these are all the Kubernetes component. So if you want to monitor and scale your metrics, so you can use the Kubelets. So it will be in the coming slide. Also, I'll tell you how to use the Kubelets. So this is the Kubernetes blueprint. So this YAML file. So this is used to orchestrate the blockchain node. So and the Docker Swarm is for interacting with the all those nodes on the Apache Brooklyn cloud platform. So here are the services Kubernetes cluster with 3 million nodes, and there's a Brooklyn config. So you can initiate these parameters with the according to your requirement, and you need to call the in the last line there's a Flannel network. So you can use Flannel, Calico, or any of the network. So here I use Flannel and the endpoint. So basically, so here in so you have to use the Flannel or Calico or some other network manager to interact with the your public network. So here is this. So here is the public network. It entered with the command line interface. So that command line interface directly interact with the Flannel and Calico, and there is a Docker engine right behind the Flannel Calico, and under this there is a kubelet, that is the kube component. So I used kubelet just to scale the metrics, and you can monitor. You have a interactive monitoring services over the Apache Brooklyn cloud platform. So so downside, there is an interaction with the browser. So it interacts with that pod, actually the pod you are running. So pod is basically the multiple containers, those we have that have shared their memory. So these are called pods. So these are the dashboard pods which you can interact via browser and the DNS pod. And on the right side there is a Kubernetes minion nodes, worker and master, which auto scales all the time. And downside there is a TLS certificate for the server that interacts with the, that call the etcd, and that interacts with the Kubernetes cluster. So this is the final Kubernetes YAML file which you can call. So we'll call the endpoint in the starting, and then we'll so this is the type. So this is the link which you can get from CloudSoft AMP, and the pod name Kubernetes. So if you named a Kubernetes pod, you can call it as Kubernetes pod, and below this you can call the. So you can combine the Docker swarm and then call it under the Kubernetes. So you can use to interact with only one node, or you can directly combine all those nodes to monitor. Like suppose you want the all log suppose you want the all log metrics of all the blockchain nodes, so you can call this so you can use this. Otherwise you don't have to use that type this Docker container name over here. So I'm using the WordPress SQL just for this demo, and you can name your here the what the name of that database. So it's MySQL over here, and you need to enter the password over here. Like suppose the password for now is password, and you can call the port here, the inbound port. So this is the WordPress configuration over here, and this is for the MySQL. So this so overall this is the WordPress MySQL. So this is the configuration for the WordPress MySQL. And here is the overall CloudSoft AMP address, which you can combine the Kubernetes YAML service and call the Kubernetes endpoint at the top of YAML file. So actually, so here I don't have a high speed internet connection, otherwise I will show you the demo. So I'll be just showing you the, so this is the Apache Brooklyn, and here you have a, so in the sidebar there are all the kube components with the